a sticker. This is for the camera.
It's a camera. So this is the sample of an advisor which is received by an agricultural expert where he receives the photographs. He receives the voice clip. What is the personal profile? His farm operations, what he have done, crop, variety, and what should we do next is being sent by the SMS at the local condition. So sir, once the DG of ICAR asked me what why you need to capture this personal profile, what you will do by knowing that he is an HSC farmer or SSC farmer. So sir, this is very important to send a personalized advice. Likewise, when we send an advice to a farmer who is an age of 45, he is a progressive farmer, we need to send the advice, what is the symptom, how we can prevent it next time. Where in the other case where the farmer is of 65 years, you just need to send that, okay, this is the chemical, spray it with this much water in your house. This is how the advisory changes with every farmer of different age. So sir, this is the type of, so sir, the voice is low, speaker is not there. So sir, the thing is that every stage when we know the date of sowing of a farmer. Okay, so we are trying to lower the idea. So these are the
subscriptions. Can you capture it in two or three sentences?
Yeah, sure. So what we find was, now everyone is focusing on the farmer, but at the same time his family is also important. Because mindset development is important. The farmer is feeling depressed and he is, you know, committing suicide. We got number of questions on our platform. We talked about, okay, I want to commit a suicide, okay, please help me, because the local government body is not helping us. Such questions also we recorded over here. Okay, so what we did was, we did a mindset development where the family of the farmer, his sons, daughter, his family, they were brought in, they were talked about climate change, they were taught about that, how climate change is affecting them. So that they are sensitized to the farmer's problem and overall community comes together and try to solve the problem. That is where we had all these kind of programs for the ladies of the village, for the children, farmers' children, and then we discuss climate change with them so that they are sensitized about the farmer. Overall, we want to say that going forward, the second generation, third generation farmer is taking up the mobile application or the mobile as a tool, scientific tool to do his farming. Precision farming is slowly coming into India, where we find that the better prediction can be done in a better way. Okay, that is how the future roadmap looks like.
We have focused on the different aspect of that point. Instead of, we cannot control the weather at such, right? But we can adapt ourselves to, like,
no,
sir, I can answer that.
We have brought this situation today.
Yes, yes, sir. But we cannot replicate at a.
So if you look at the fertilizer case,
yes.
Encyclopedia meaning that giving information on many subjects or many aspects of one subject. So, yeah, so we are taking agriculture as. Yes, sir. Actually not. Yes, actually not. But,
agriculture.
I need not talk about the basic agriculture part. I hope we all know about agriculture. I will talk about the problems and the current agriculture system here. So we can see that there are over 58% of the rural households depend on agriculture in our country. So and
you
there
can
are
see this time.
Okay. And there are various local and global issues, like we can see climate change, degrading land quality, increasing demand for quantity and quality, disasters, and the local issues we are suffering from, that is the lack of education, uneven distribution of profit, poor communication in rural areas, and manual ineffective systems, and no real-time updated information is provided to our farmers, and unemployment and many more such issues are there. So, and we need to have a sustainable agriculture. So, we can achieve by including technology in this field of agriculture. So, technology, as we know, it is very dynamic and it is present in many fields too. And it can also transform the lifestyle of the farmers. So, then if we say climate change, we see that very drastic changes affect the farmers, agriculture and everything. So, we need a solution for that. The next one is...
climate, which parameters?
Everything. Temperature, greenhouse. Actually, I must.
You are mentioning all these things.
Yes.
You mean it?
Yes, sir. Actually, it means not enough. You must say.
No, but you pinpoint yourself.
Yeah. We already know that our country is the fourth largest greenhouse gas emitter and also accounting for 5.8 global emissions. So it comes into picture that yes, you said CO2 and all greenhouse gases, rainfall, temperature changes, then as आपण बघतो की गारपीट पण खूप ठिकाणी होतं आणि गारपीटामुळे पिका पण एक आय पी सी सीच एक आर्टिकल मी मेन्शन करतो की इंटरनॅशनल बॉडी आहे आणि ती इंडिकेट करते की राईस अँड वीट प्रोडक्शन ऑफ इंडिया विल ड्रॉप सिग्निफिकंटली बिकॉज ऑफ क्लायमेट चेंज आणि 1.5 डिग्री सेल्सियस राईस अँड 2 मिलीमीटर इन्क्रीज इन प्रेसिपिटेशन टू रिझल्ट इन अ डिक्लाईन इन राईस यील्ड्स बाय 3 to 5%. सो किती ड्रॅस्टिक चेंज आणि किती अफेक्ट होतं हे क्लायमेट चेंज या सगळ्या गोष्टी.
What is the production of rice and wheat?
So
then you said 3 to 5% would be reduced. What is the present production of rice and wheat? You know?
Yes, sir. Actually,
you should have stated for that.
Yeah.
Alright.
Then degrading land quality. Due to that water and wind erosion, then land erosion due to chemical excessive chemicals, fertilizers, it affects agriculture like that. Then due to increasing demand and quantity for quality, due to increasing population, there is a increasing demand. Then epidemics and diseases caused due to improper sanitation and everything. And also in agriculture, I don't know much, but industrial agriculture also, some experts say that industrial agriculture is making sick.
What is industrial agriculture?
Actually, my aim is different. I'm just giving information. This is my project.
You
which
you know
okay, okay. I will go forward.
मॅडम थोडा वेळ वाढून द्या ना
त्यांना.
मग आपल्यामध्ये प्रश्न बघू
शकतो.
Lack of education, which also affects in rural areas. Then distribution of profit, it is major in India. Distribution. Farmers la tyancha profit need mhelala mhelat nahi tyachyavar hoye pan effect hoto. Then communication. Communication is also another thing. Rural areas paryanta high speed data, high speed internet ajun pochle nahi. Mi baras experience kelele swatah. Then ineffective system. सिस्टीम आत्ता मॅन्युअल आहे म्हणजे खूपच इनइफेक्टिव्ह आहे आणि आम्ही मी या प्रोजेक्टमध्ये हे मॅन्युअल सिस्टीम मी कॉम्प्युटर सायन्स यूज करून माझं कॉम्प्युटर सायन्स एज्युकेशन यूज करून मी हे डेव्हलप करतो आहे आणि ऑटोमेट करण्याचा प्रयत्न करतो आहे. देन अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट इज अ मेजर इश्यू इन रुरल एरियाज. लेट्स सी माय मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव्ह इन दिस प्रोजेक्ट. बेनिफिट टू फार्मर्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ प्रोडक्ट प्राइस. Then creating a perfect system such that in future farmers would not have a tough life. Providing information and educating all about agriculture so that the production output and quality will be good. Increasing awareness among the people on topics like global warming, irregular climate change, natural disasters, etc. Increasing demand for agriculture sector. Then decreasing unemployment by boosting primary field and secondary fields like IT industry, packaging and transport businesses. Providing high speed network to the rural areas for better communication and connectivity and creating smart villages. Now, this is my system. We have suggested an online system to solve most of our problems in agriculture without affecting nature and which in turn almost solves every some major issues in our country. Our system is an online portal which can be website or application software to help farmers, which would be better for our country. Then online portal will be user friendly and will also be available in regional languages so that everyone can understand it. This system will have 7 entities. Here the entities are the active users in our system. Then it will also contain certain functions. We will now discuss briefly the entities. Farmer, he is our main stakeholder. They will be the backbone of the system. Their main responsibility in the system will be providing people with good quality food and at a reasonable price. And price shall be quoted by the farmer itself, but you should not manipulate the market price which will be quoted by the market analyst in our system. So, and farmers, yes, farmers can be customers themselves. Then comes the market analyst. Market analysts are the people who are going to set market price for each agriculture product every day in our system. This price shall be the selling price for the farmer's product while trading, and market analysis will also check the trading transparency and manipulation. That is, any person who puts price more than the standards set by the market analyst will have to reset the prices while trading. So it will not manipulate the market, and nobody will complain that prices are gone high and everything. Then customers, we know the customer's role required for is to purchase the required products from the farmers and to see and to appreciate and respect the hard work of the farmers. Then they should also check the quality of the product as per the quality standards set by quality check committee. There is also a quality check committee in our system which will be they will have standard checking grading system. Then it will come to the packaging and transport agencies. Different agriculture products required different packaging system. Then if the packing is proper, then the food product till it reaches the customer will not be spoiled. And same the transport agencies should have to reach the product in time. Then experts. In our system, we have academic experts like professors of agriculture college, different heads of departments, etc., and professional experts who are much experienced in this field, and they are going to solve the critical problems of the farmer and give suggestions to them. And then last, the NGO and government officials, they must be actively present on the system so that farmers can get help from both types of organizations. Then we will come to the functions. As you said, we have a function that is information provider. It is, I will make it in one sentence, it is like if you know Google search engine. It is a Google search engine. My information provider system is a Google search engine only for agriculture. So even everyone's research papers, everyone research will be present in my information provider. Then, and basic information to who are new to this agriculture, they will also get information regarding, and they can start farming. Then we will also provide use of maps and travels too, so that farmers and customers can get to know that where what production is more, which type of production, which type of food is more, like that. And also climatic soil graphs, then climatic graphs and like that. Then we will go to training function. Here there are two aspects. Consumer will buy the agriculture products for farmer, and second aspect is the farmer will buy farming essentials which from manufacturer which are required for its farming, and we are also giving an extra feature for it that a farmer can rent a tool for some time, and he can use it. That is, he does not have to invest forever in that tool. Then market analysis, as I said. Yes, that's product. Market analysis, product quality assurance, we said packaging, ask the expert, as I said, government and NGO support, finance. Finance here we are providing banking, online transaction for customers, banking system, cash on delivery at these functions. Then the 24/7 online and offline help will help farmers and customers. Through live chat, telecommunication, mobile phones and etc. And feedback for customers and farmers itself. Yes, conclusion. Our system is easy to use and understand. Our system solves most of the problems with the farmers. It helps by selling this product at right price, improving lifestyles and savings for the future. Yeah, yes, banks also provide the schemes, various related schemes for their for farmers and as well as the students. And just 1 minute, I would like to just observe this slide. Just I need to observe this slide.
What is the name of your tool? Just keep that so that those who are interested can get it.
Earth farmers. Earth. And this is what we want to achieve.
You are saying you yourself have experienced that there is no coverage in many of the areas,
yeah.
And you are making portal for them. How will you help?
Yes. My project will be partnered with network providers, network provider companies, which will be local and international. Things like we, there are local internet providers also like Apple and also the network providers which are we are using that. Our project will be partnered with the network agency.
But can you just give the name of the portal so that you know if anyone is interested to just go and have a link? Give the batch.
Yes,
thank you. But what is your website?
Yeah, that is the name. That is the name itself.
That is the website.
No, we are actually, I'm trying to promote. I will be developing this after my.
It is not yet ready.
Not yet.
Okay.
इसरायच्या आधी मी बी बी एसच्या ऑर्गनायझर्सना माझा धन्यवाद देतो आणि मी आज भारतातील गव्हाचा ती वापर आणि त्याचा इतिहास याच्याबद्दल बोलतो आहे. आदरणीय बापट सर आणि माझे मित्र, मी एक 10 ते 15 स्लाइड्स केल्या 10 मिनिटांचा. तर गहू ही मानवाला निसर्गाने दिलेली एक देणगी आहे. कारण का देणगी आहे, तर ह्या गव्हामुळेच आज आपण आपल्या जवळजवळ दिवसाच्या 20 ते 25 किलो म्हणजे 20 ते 25% कॅलरीज गव्हामुळे घेतो. आज जगात जवळजवळ 770 मिलियन मेट्रिक टन्स हे प्रोडक्शन आहे, मेज पहिल्यांदा आहे आणि वीट नंतर. तर गव्हाचा उगम हा जवळजवळ मध्यपूर्व एशिया फर्टाईल क्रिसेंट इथे झाला. 16,000 ते 17,000 वर्षांपूर्वी एपिपेलिओलिथिक माणूस जो शिकार करत फिरत होता, इकडे फिर तिकडे फिर, शिकार मिळेल तिथे थांब, नंतर परत फिर असं, तर त्याला हा गहू दिसला आणि त्यांनी नंतर ह्या गव्हामुळे आणि इतर काही बार्ली, तीळ, जवस ह्या काही क्रॉप्समुळे एकीकडे स्थिरावून राहायचं